tumors are regressing in a way that we really haven't seen with any other form of therapy that we have available for patients now. So
a powerful statement, and this is what's behind it. Two brain scans of a glioblastoma patient's tumor, the one on the right showing the tumor is dramatically smaller after just one dose of the new therapy, now in early clinical trials at Mass General Cancer Center.
We collect T cells from the patient's blood, engineer them with this CAR-T molecule, and then put them back into the fluid around the brain.
Dr. Marcella Moss and Dr. Brian Choi are leading the team, taking a form of immunotherapy that's used to fight other cancers and adding a new layer to target stubborn and deadly glioblastoma brain tumors. CAR-T cell therapy uses the body's own T cells to fight a patient's cancer, but using it to fight brain tumors hasn't been successful because the brain is so highly protected. This new therapy uses a team approach, injecting engineered cells into the fluid around the brain where they train other T cells to zero in on the tumor and kill it.
It's been several decades before we've even had a therapy that has moved the needle at all in terms of prolonging the survival of patients with this cancer. So in a way, it's unprecedented.
Tom Frazier is one of three patients taking part in this trial. The 72-year-old father and grandfather saw his tumor shrink by more than 60%, and the results of that single low dose of therapy lasted for 6 months. In a statement, Frazier said he felt extremely fortunate to have found this trial when he did, saying it was the most promising cutting-edge treatment available, and we immediately knew this exciting trial could actually help me and possibly many others in the future. For Moss and Choi, the fact that similar efforts are taking place in labs and hospitals around the country means that a breakthrough is on the horizon.
I think we're all learning from each other, and I think it means that there's sort of multiple shots on goal.
Yeah, providing so much hope. As we mentioned, this is the early stages. The first trial was really about making sure the treatment was safe. They now hope to shift to a larger trial with more patients, more data, and potentially repeated doses of the injection combined with chemotherapy. We'll, of course, keep you posted on their progress.